Hi guys, it's Marty here from letsbuildwp.com, and in this video we're going to be covering how to install WordPress on HostGator web hosting using the built-in cPanel. I'm going to cover the entire process step by step and in a way that anyone should be able to understand. Plus, I'll even show you how to get your first month web hosting with them for only one penny. Now, I did already post a video covering how to do this a while back, but since then a few things have changed, and I've had a few people telling me that it's outdated. So this is the newest, up-to-date version recorded in late 2018. And if you're ready to get started, this is how to install WordPress on HostGator web hosting. Okay, so the first thing we need to do is just sign up for an account by going to HostGator.com. Or alternatively, you can just click the link below this video. Either way, once we get here, we just need to click Web Hosting in the top left, and that's going to show us the three different hosting plans that HostGator offer. To be totally honest with you, the business plan comes with a whole load of added extras we probably won't need at this time, so that really just leaves it between the hatchling plan and the baby plan. The only real difference between these two plans is that the hatchling plan allows us one single website, while the baby plan allows us to have as many websites as we'd like. So if you're only planning to have one website or blog, go for the hatchling plan, or if you're going to have more than one site, go for the baby plan. As I'm just doing this for the tutorial, I'm going to go for the hatchling plan, and once you've decided on which plan you're going to go for, just click underneath where it says Buy Now. That's going to bring us to this page, which is where we can register the domain name for our new site. All we need to do is type the domain we'd like to use into this box, so for me I'm going to type WP Smartway. Then on the right hand side, using this drop down, we can choose the domain extension we'd like to use. So for me I'm going to go for the .com, but you might want to use something else like .net or .org. Once we've chosen our domain name and extension, hopefully it comes up and says added, primary, and this means the domain's available for us to register. Once we've chosen our domain name, we also have the option to buy other domain extensions as well, so we could purchase the .com version of our domain, as well as some other ones like .org or .net. But we can always come back and purchase these later as well if we like. Then underneath we'll see here it says Domain Privacy Protection, which is a 100% optional add-on. To be honest, I normally just uncheck this box and haven't had any problems to date. But if you want to keep your site totally anonymous, just leave this box checked and it'll be added to your bill. Then underneath it says Choose a Hosting Plan, and here we just want to check that our package type is correct and choose a billing cycle. So I chose the hatchling plan at the start, so this is correct, and then underneath we can choose how often we'd like to pay for our hosting. We can pay for it once every month, every 6 months, or we can even pay for it every 3 years if we like. Now, we do save a bit more money the longer we buy at one time, so that might be something to think about. As I'm just doing this for the tutorial, I'm going to set mine to monthly. Then underneath we just need to create a username and security pin for use with HostGator, and then under this we can enter our personal billing information. So that's our name, our email address, and things like that. Then on the right hand side we can choose how we'd like to pay for our order, and we can choose either credit or debit card, or PayPal. Then under this we'll see it says Add Additional Services, and these are a few paid services that HostGator offer. I normally just uncheck these boxes myself, but you can have a read through them, and if you like the look of any of them, just leave the box checked and it'll be added to your bill. Now, you might see here we get a free SSL certificate, and these normally cost sort of $10 to $20, so it's pretty awesome that we get this included with our order. Then under this it says enter a coupon code, and as I mentioned at the start of this video, I'm going to give you a coupon code that'll get you your first month hosting for only one penny. Now, there might already be a coupon code entered in here worth 20 or 25% off, but instead of using this coupon code, we're just going to delete it, and instead we're going to enter install WP1. So that's the word install, the letters WP, and then the number 1. Then when we click validate, we'll see underneath we're now getting our first month hosting for only 1 penny. Now this is awesome if we're only going to be purchasing a few months hosting at one time, but if we're going to be ordering more than 6 months, there's an even better coupon we can use. If we use the coupon HOSTING30 instead, we can get 30% off our entire order, which can obviously work out a lot better if our bill's a little higher. If you're unsure, you can always try both coupons and see which one works out better for you. And please feel free to leave a comment underneath letting me know which one worked out better. Then, once we've entered our coupon, underneath we just want to check that our order is correct. Also be sure to note the 45-day money-back guarantee and the 24/7 phone, live chat and email support, which can be extremely helpful if we get stuck. Then as long as we're happy with everything here, we just need to scroll down to the bottom, check this box to agree to the terms, and then click checkout now. So I'm just going to quickly pause this video while I fill out my billing information above and pay for my order, and then I'll be right back. Okay, so that's me now back, and when I finished paying for my order, it brought me to a thank you page, and then redirected me to the home page. At this point, we just need to open up our email inbox in a new tab, and we should find a few new emails from HostGator. These are pretty important emails, so we need to keep them safe, but for now, we just want to click into the email labeled Your Account Info. In this email, we'll see we have a link to our control panel, also known as our cPanel, our username and password for logging in, and some other pretty important information. So now we just need to click the link to our control panel, which will open up our cPanel login screen in a new tab. Then we just want to copy and paste our username and password from this email into the cPanel login screen. Then we just need to click login, and this is us going to be logging into the HostGator cPanel. Now this might seem a little overwhelming at first, but it's actually pretty easy. All we need to do is scroll down to where it says software, and then click quick install. Then we can just select WordPress in the middle, or if we don't see this, we can click one click installs on the left, and then select WordPress here. Either way, that's going to bring us to this page, and here we just need to select our new domain name from this drop down list, and then click Next. Then on this page, we're just going to enter some basic information for our WordPress site. So for blog title, this is just going to be the name of our WordPress website, and for me, I'm just going to type my new website. Although don't worry too much about this for now, we can always change this later. Then admin user is going to be the username for logging into our site, and it's also going to be visible on a few different pages as well. Then we just need to enter our first name, our last name, and our email address. Then underneath, we just need to check this box to agree to the terms of service, and then click install. HostGator's then going to install WordPress for us automatically in a matter of seconds. Once it's finished, we'll be given a link to our site, our username, and a randomly generated password. At this point, we just want to right-click the login button and click Open Link in New Tab. This is then going to open up the WordPress login screen in a new tab. Now we just want to copy and paste our username and password from this screen into the login screen. Then when we click Login, this is us going to be logging into what's known as the WordPress dashboard, which is where we can add any content or make any changes to our new site, which, by the way, is now live online. All we need to do to visit our site is click our site title in the top left, and that's going to show us the default WordPress installation. Then to get back to our WordPress dashboard, we just need to click our site title again in the top left. So that's us now finished, and that was how to install WordPress on HostGator web hosting. If you managed to follow along at home, please leave a comment underneath saying you did it and tell me what type of site you're planning to build. I'd really love to hear this, and I'll always try to help wherever I can. If you liked the video, please give it a like here on YouTube to show your support, and consider subscribing to the channel for more WordPress tutorials like this one published every week. Then finally, if you want to learn how to use WordPress now that you have it installed, you can join my free WordPress 101 course by going to letsbuildwp.com/keeplearning. The course covers things like changing themes, adding pages, creating menus, and everything else you'll need to know in order to build a website or blog with WordPress. So just go to letsbuildwp.com/keeplearning to get free lifetime access to the course. Once again, my name's Marty from letsbuildwp.com, and thank you very much for watching my video.